Hello everyone and welcome to Pete and Vinnie Play. Today we have another reaction video for you guys. And this one is pretty special because we didn't plan on doing it at all. We were just on YouTube doing some research for the channel when YouTube suggested this classic Paul Gilbert solo.
So as many of you probably know, Vinnie and I are massive Paul Gilbert fans. We kind of think of him as our main guy. And the first ever video we did on Pete and Vinnie Play was a cover of Technical Difficulties by Racer X, which many of you continue to watch and enjoy to this day, so we're very appreciative of that. So yeah, we're excited to revisit this classic video of Paul.
Yeah, exactly. So just to be clear, we've both seen this video before, but I think I've seen it last time about 10 years ago.
About the same for me, probably.
Yeah, exactly. So we thought it would be cool to watch it again after such a long time, because obviously in 10 years, you change a lot as a player.
Let's do it.
You ready?
Yeah, man.
Paul Gilbert!
Yeah, man, check that out. Trousers?
Yeah, yeah. Keeping time with his head.
He was so skinny. He was so skinny. Yeah, yeah. I guess he's always been. He's still skinny.
Yeah, yeah. He's just a really tall guy.
Look at the amount of gain as well, man. Very gainy sound.
Just walking casually.
What a rock star, yeah. Man. You know?
He's not even looking at all.
No. Just being proper rock star.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can really hear his attack when he gets to the higher strings as well.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what it really cuts through.
It's icy,
yeah,
like.
Yeah.
It's, yeah.
I don't think he's looked at the fretboard once.
Oh, here he goes. His signature sound.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Love how he plays this with the thumb over top as well, because his hands are so huge.
Yeah, he's got that Hendrix thing going on, you know?
Even playing like that, you know? Like the opposite of blues licks, but he still had to...
Yeah, he's like shred with the thumb over. Yeah. That's a good point, actually, yeah.
I never really noticed that before, to be honest.
And he can still reach, you know, you can see he can still reach.
Yeah, he's got hands out to here.
If he wants to stretch his pinky up, he can easily reach the sixth string, you know.
Those red boots as well.
Yeah, he's got the whole shebang, man. That's early 90s, 1991.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's the classic late 80s, early 90s hair metal look.
Bar going on there with his third finger.
Yeah!
I'm not sure. Play that clean.
Do you think it was an accident or do you think.
No, when he starts repeating the lick, you can see it's.
Oh, he wants that note.
Yeah! But I'm just amazed he can play that clean with the bar.
Yeah, man.
It's like my worst enemy, bars with his third finger.
Because you get the dreaded four,
the minor third. Yeah, if you're on the B string and the G.
Yeah, or the minor third. That's a proper crowd as well, isn't it?
I hear the blues. I love how Paul just—he blends blues licks with just
and it's very seamless as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he'll start a bend to a blues lick. You think he's gonna go with his sound, you know?
Yeah. How used to that kind of life do you have to be able to go in front of all those people and play like that, that clean, that precise, you know, and like with such charisma as well, you know?
Yeah, it's crazy.
You need to kind of do it every day.
Yeah,
it's like 10 years.
You guys have been doing it your whole life, you know. Yeah.
I think this is the best. If I remember correctly, this is like it's funny.
Oh, I forgot about this bit. Oh my god.
Come on, that sound.
Mate,
that's his sound. That's his sound. Well, yeah. Sounds like that. Come on.
Controlling the whole room with his guitar.
Basically, yeah. Yeah, the
getting
control.
Getting them to respond. Yeah. It's all free up for stringing E minor, which I find pretty cool.
Yeah, that's his favorite key, though. Yeah, it's always been.
It's not
yeah, really, yeah. How savage is that, man?
With his pinky as well.
Yeah, man. I never kind of got
yeah,
used to playing
man.
It was never my thing, you know.
Yeah, what a professional.
Yeah.
Look how wide the gap is between his third and fourth fingers as well.
Yeah,
you know?
That's the thing about him. His pinky is really independent.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
He can do really, really strong. He's always been able to do all these like really strong pull-offs with
yeah.
it, you know? I think that one thing I find really impressive, man, is just the energy of this. You know, like
yeah.
the attack, you know, you can see like it's a young guy
yeah.
really kind of going for it, you know.
But what's cool as well is that all comes from his playing. Because if you look at it, he's just kind of chilling.
Yeah,
he's
relaxed.
He's walking
yeah.
a bit, but
yeah.
he's just like, yeah, he's relaxed.
He's not
yeah.
tense, he's not aggressive.
You know?
He's just nice
yeah.
and relaxed.
Yeah.
But like the aggressiveness of the sound and the, like, in the playing, it's just like, it's just like you don't see this all the time.
Yeah.
Even though with,
I think that's what gives Paul his sound, like you were saying. It's just,
yeah.
like, you know. The savageness, the attack, is what, you know, what comes from him.
Look at that beautiful right hand, man. He can make those classic for string patterns sound exciting
and he's playing major right
yeah.
now as well. It's still like oh.
he's not even playing to me any music
yeah.
and it's entertaining to watch, you know. Yeah, and obviously the fact that Japanese people love technique so much
yeah.
really helps because they're in Budokan, you know. Oh, he's going for the drill!
Yes!
Good
point of Van Halen.
Classic. Makita vintage drill. He always talks about this. It needs to be a vintage drill because the more modern ones, they stop straight away. So you don't get
oh,
the...
Oh, right. So, it's like, yeah. so those take a while to slow down.
Yeah, exactly. So you get
yeah.
that kind of
yeah.
squealy sound,
yeah, yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
He had three or four picks. He had three and then four. And then he went back to three picks, but I think it's four by
yeah.
the looks of it.
My goodness, look at the smoke coming off the drill.
Yes, mate! Oh, Billy's
coming
back,
yeah.
yeah. Oh, he's got a drill as well. Oh, there we go.
That's really good.
Man, honestly,
yeah.
I have to say, man, like I was waiting till the end to say this, but just watching it now, about 10 years later, just makes me appreciate even more. Because when I was, say, when I was watching it when I was like, I don't know, 16 or whatever, the vibe I remember clearly having from this video was like, oh, he's really good.
Yeah.
You know? But as a whole, you know?
Yeah,
I don't think
yeah.
I was able back then to identify elements of how amazing like it sounded, you know,
yeah.
but now kind of after like obviously studying guitar and being a bit of a better player, you can go like, look at that look at the picking, look at the patterns, you know?
Going off of that point, I think, yeah, now we can appreciate how many hours go into making
And according to him in interviews, he said it before that he's been super sharp like that since the age of like 16, you know? So can you imagine how crazy he's like, how much he actually practiced?
He's a hard worker on top of all of that.
Exactly.
You know,
he's one of those kind of effort meets talent kind of guy, you know?
I would pay to see 40 minutes of that.
Just in your face, play. Yeah.
I would go to a gig with just that. You
know? That's a really good one, yeah.
Honestly, I would.
Very cool, man. Very cool. So there you go, guys. Thank you for watching this impromptu reaction video from us. Now, we really enjoy doing this. So if you think there's any other classic guitar videos you think we should revisit, please let us know in the comments and we'll make sure that happens for you guys.
And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Let us know what you thought in the comments. What are your thoughts on the video? And consider subscribing to our channel for more videos just like this. So until next time, see ya.